Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. In 2015, Space News from the Electric Universe reported on a, quote, baffling mystery on the planet Mars. Science news headlines reported on seemingly inexplicable plumes, which amateur astronomers spotted rising hundreds of kilometers above the surface of Mars. An analysis published in the journal Nature in February of 2015 argued that the plumes were clouds of frozen carbon dioxide and water particles, even though clouds never form that high in the upper atmosphere of Mars. Others suggested volcanic activity, while some hypothesized that the plumes were a kind of aurora since they appeared above a known pocket of magnetization on Mars, called a magnetic anomaly. But the Nature report stated of this hypothesis, this would require an increased flow of charged particles from the Sun, and its activity was not unusually high during the time. However, a team of scientists using data from the Mars Express spacecraft have found something completely unexpected to planetary scientists. A coronal mass ejection appeared to hit Mars immediately before the plume was first spotted. The team leader, David Andrews, of the Swedish Institute of Space Physics, says of this discovery, it's very surprising that was affecting Mars right before the plume was first observed. Andrews states of the hypothesis that a CME caused the plume. We're not completely convinced ourselves. At best, all we can say is there is an interesting correlation between two rather extreme events. A New Scientist report on these findings states, one possibility is that plasma could be interacting with ice grains or dust lower down in the atmosphere and electrically charging them, boosting them higher. But it's not clear how the effect would be big. Let us now look back to the March 14, 2015 episode of Space News from the Electric Universe, entitled Baffling Mars Plumes Are Electric. At the time, we compared the Martian plumes to the giant dust fountains on the Moon, first seen in the 1960s. We noted the fairly recent discovery that Earth's magnetotail creates powerful electric fields near the lunar surface, occasionally causing dramatic dust storms. As noted by NASA scientist Tim Stubbs in 2008, Earth's magnetotail extends well beyond the orbit of the Moon, and once a month, the Moon orbits through it. This can have consequences ranging from lunar dust storms to electrostatic discharges. For many years, the chief principals of the Thunderbolts Project have argued that dramatic dust-raising events on Mars are electrical in nature, and are primarily driven by the planet's electromagnetic connection to the Sun. Although Mars' atmosphere is less than 1% as dense as Earth's, so-called dust devils on Mars sometimes reach as tall as Mount Everest, and the global Martian dust storms have been a puzzle for planetary scientists for decades. With such a tenuous atmosphere, how is dust removed from the soil and accelerated to form massive clouds circling the planet, up to 40 miles or more above the surface? Let us consider the greatest dust storm ever observed on Mars in 2001. Which began in late June and did not begin to subside until October. What excavated the dust from the surface? What held the dust aloft? What accelerated the winds and dust across the near vacuum of Mars's upper atmosphere to speeds greater than 250 miles per hour? As with the mystery of the baffling Martian plumes, the answer is electrical. In the 2005 Thunderbolts picture of the day, when dust storms engulf Mars, a theoretical foundation was laid for a new understanding of dust-raising events and other extreme atmospheric phenomena on Mars. The article states, since Mars has no thunderstorms to charge up its ionosphere, it should present a good case study for the electric universe. The electrical model predicts that the Martian ionosphere is indeed charged, and it posits no isolated dynamo to separate charge. On Mars, electrical effects will reach directly from the ionosphere to the surface without the ameliorating leakage via storm clouds we see on Earth. Unlike radiant energy from the Sun, electrical energy can accumulate in the planetary capacitor for some time, with the potential for planet-altering events when the atmosphere finally breaks down and massive discharge activity is initiated. What might cause such a dielectric breakdown in the Martian atmosphere? In addition to charged particles from the Sun, we have noted one other potential factor. In the aforementioned 2005 article, the Thunderbolts Project noted that when the greatest dust storm ever observed on Mars began in 2001, Mars had reached opposition, and was the closest it had been to Earth in about 12 years. We also suggest it may not be a coincidence that, in March of 2012, just days before the baffling Martian plumes were observed, Mars was again at opposition and was its closest proximity to Earth in over 2 years. A new electrical interpretation of dust-racing phenomena on the red planet may lead to a better understanding of similar phenomena on other planets and moons. We have noted that the baffling Mars plumes bear a striking resemblance to the plumes on the Jovian moon Io, as well as the Saturnian moon Enceladus. While planetary scientists have long believed that cryovolcanoes due to tidal heating are the cause of the plumes, in the case of Io, the tidal heating model has failed to predict the location of the plumes. NASA scientists now acknowledge that electrical currents connect Jupiter and Saturn with their respective moons. In the extremely electrified environments of the gas giants, it is reasonable to suggest that high-energy electrical discharges on the moon's surfaces are excavating and jetting material up to hundreds of kilometers high. The playwright George Bernard Shaw once stated, "Progress is impossible without change, and those who cannot change their minds cannot change anything." But real change is happening in the space sciences, as new discoveries lead scientists incrementally toward the concepts of the electric universe.
For continuous updates on space news from the electric universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.